Hi everyone, welcome to the RPB Resonance Chemistry. Now let us continue with our lectures on biomolecules, lecture number 2. In this session we will discuss the amino acids, like introduction part, and zwitter ions, isoelectric point, as well as electrophoresis effect. So before going to those topics, I'll continue yesterday class within just 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, in previous case we will discuss the many of the amino acids based on their classification, the generally occurrence, location, like a chemical nature, as well as positions, like in different manners, that is chemical nature. Okay, in different manner we will consider like essential, non-essential, acidic, basic, natural, semi-synthesized, synthesized, such type of classification. Okay, now however, among all the compounds except glycine, all are chiralmites. Again, in case of like threonine, this is the compound here, NH2COOH, that is a H. Okay, now here OHCH3, this is called threonine. Okay, threonine. Okay, as well as isoleucine. Okay, now here in this case this is called isoleucine. Okay, HCOOH, like NH2. So among all the compounds, threonine as well as isoleucine, these having additional chiral center, which is shown in the like asterisk symbol. Okay, so all the amino acids having the only one chiral center except glycine, but these two having the additional chiral center. So if two chiral centers are there, that means here it gives the four types of isomers. Among the four isomers, only one is active. So we will discuss those active isomers only. Okay, now those point, I mentioned those point, threonine as well as isoleucine. Isoleucine having more like two chiral centers. Okay, now another point, the third point, all the amino acids are S configuration except cysteine. So general, the representation of amino acid, this is the like a Fischer projection, here NH2H, like this, here it may be like a methyl or alanine, those type of compounds, which is simply represented by the this type of representation, hydrogen, here it is the above the plane. Now COOH, like NH2, this is the compound. Okay, now here it is methylene. So 1, like 2, it is the 3, it is 4. So now the rotation like this. So in this case, this type of rotation is anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise rotation, that is nothing but S configuration. Now however, in case of like a Fischer projection, now here 1, 2, like 3, 4. So the rotation like this, here it is the clockwise rotation, but least priority group on horizontal plane. So the stereochemistry is reverse. So clockwise is R, but a least priority group on the horizontal plane, the R stereochemistry will reverse. That is the S configuration. But except cysteine, that means here it is the like a CH2, like SH. Now here C double bond OH. Here it is the like NH2. Okay, now here it is the first priority, here it is the fourth priority, doesn't matter. Okay, but in all the cases COOH is the second priority, but in case of a sulfur containing amino acids, that means according to the CIP, Korn-Ingold-Prelog rules, sulfur having the more atomic number when compared to the three oxygens. Now here it is the three oxygens. Okay, so double bonds considered as a multiple bond, that's why these carbon atom connected to the three oxygens. So each oxygen, three eights are 24, but here only one sulfur is 32, so that's why, so here it is the more priority number when compared to the oxygen. So here it is the third priority, here it is the third priority. So the rotation like this, so rotation is anti-clockwise, but least priority is there. So anti-clockwise, yes becomes R. Now here cysteine is R configuration isomer. Okay, all amino acids or S configuration except cysteine. Okay, so this is the like a RS nomenclature of amino acids. Okay, now the finally, again I'll explain the DL configuration, all are L configuration. All are L configuration.
So here all the amino acids are L configuration, not the D configuration, based on the relative configuration. Okay, these 4 points I missed out over the like previous class. So now here this is the introduction of like amino acid lectures. Okay, now let us go through the Zwitterion. Let us go through the Zwitterion part. Now let us discuss the Zwitterion. Okay, so before going to the Zwitterion, now let us discuss the some of the physical properties of like amino acids. So amino acids are like non-volatile crystalline solids, non-volatile crystalline solids, crystalline compounds, again, which is non-insoluble in non-polar solvents, insoluble in non-polar solvents. Okay, so in generally non-polar like a benzene, like petroleum ether, benzene, petroleum ether, normal ether, such type of compounds which are non-soluble, but they are soluble in water, soluble in water, again due to the like hydrogen bonding, so peptide linkages, like sorry, I don't want to go for the like proteins. Now here the amino acids, here so amino acids having the high melting point temperature, at high temperature it is melted, high melting point. Okay, high melting point. Okay, now here these are the like properties of amino acid. So now the first of all, it is non-volatile crystalline compound. So here the crystalline nature which is came from the formation of Zwitterion salt, Zwitterion. Okay, due to the formation of Zwitterion, so those amino acids are crystalline compounds. Those amino acids are crystalline compounds. Now let us discuss those Zwitterions, why it is formed the like crystalline compounds. Okay, now let us go through the Zwitterion. So Zwitterion is nothing but a proton transferred from carboxylic acid group to like ammonium or like amine group. Now let us discuss, here it is the like simplest representation of amino acid. Here it is COOH, H, here it is the R. Okay, now here it is the lone pairs, amine group having the lone pairs. So now COOH, here it is a more acidic proton. Okay, now these acidic proton will transfer to the amine group. That means so the lone pair of electrons of ammonia will abstract the proton. So the abstraction of a proton, which is nothing but basic character. Now the loss of a proton, which is nothing but acidic character. Okay, now the acidic nature of COOH group and basic nature of NH2 groups, both are present over the like a same compound. That's why it gives the like NH3 plus and COO minus, which gives the salt, which gives the a crystalline salt. So this salt is a crystalline compound. That salt, which is nothing but a Zwitterion. So due to the formation of this salt, all the amino acids are like a solid, like a crystalline solid structures. Now here, those are called Zwitterion. So this is the neutral compound. This is also neutral compound. 1 plus 1 minus is neutral. So this is the like a general representation of neutral compound, but does not existed, which is the existed neutral compound. So this is the like acid-base reaction. Now here one is the acidic group and another one is the like basic group. So amine lone pairs will act as a base, like a COOH H plus will act as a acidic compound, Now here proton transfer takes place. So simply Zwitterion, which forms the like a proton transfer from carboxylic acid group to amine group, and it forms the ammonia cation and carboxylate anion. So those positive and negative charges present over the same compound, those compounds are called Zwitterion. So in this case, both positive and negative formed the adjacent position, then it is called halides. We will discuss the like sulfur as well as phosphorus halides. Okay, so this is the Zwitterion. Zwitterion generally forms like three types of isomers. Now I'll discuss those three types of isomers of Zwitterions. Okay, now let us take the one example, that is alanine as our example. Now here it is NH2, this is COOH, this is H, like a CH3. So this is the alanine compound. So simple amino acid is glycine. So whenever R is equal to CH3, then a simple alkyl group is present, then it is alanine. Okay, so it's not a simple amino acid. Simple amino acid is nothing but glycine. Okay, now here it is the alanine. Okay, in alanine, it existed as a crystalline compound, that means it existed zwitter ion, so that is a NH3 plus and COO minus at pH 6, almost a neutral pH. At neutral pH, like it's not the exact neutral, somewhat closer to the neutral. At neutral pH, it existed as a zwitter ion, Now, let us discuss whenever these amino acid solution will added to the, like some of the, like a strong acidic solution, okay, which is added to the strong acid solution, that means H plus. Now here the pH value of the alanine is 6. Now whenever I'll add the like a strong acid, pH value almost all decreased, or pH value almost all suppressed up to less than 2, pH value less than or equal to the 2. Okay, so if pH value less than or equal to the 2, that means it is acidic solution. In case of acidic solution, it gives the, or it donates the protons to the, like a basic compounds. Now here, it is ammonia, cation, it is not a basic. So here it is the, like a salt form, that is quaternary. Now here, COO minus, which is a lack of proton, now which is ready to take the proton from acidic compound. Now here, which takes the proton, now it converts the COH, like C, NH3 plus, now here H, here it is the CH3. Okay, so this is the simplest compound. Whenever these type of neutral solution which is added to the strong acid, it gives the like a pH less than 2 solution, it gives the COOH and NH3 plus. So in this case, we will observe only cations, So now here we will observe at less than pH 2, so we will observe only cations, that is amino acid becomes a cation. Now instead of like a strong acid, I will add it to the like a strong base solution, strong basic solution, that is a like OH minus concentration. So if it is a strong base, then pH value rises to the greater than 7. So that means pH value is raised to the greater than 7. So that indicates, so our solution will abstract the proton from amino acid. Now here, among these two compounds, here it is not the acidic compound. Now among the NH3, one of the proton will readily abstracted by the base. Now our solution will abstract the proton. Now it creates the like COO minus, as usually hydrogen NH2. Okay, now in case of basic solution, that means highest pH value solution, it appears as anions. So at the less pH value, it is cation. At high pH value, it is the anion. So now our zwitter ion will give the these three types of ions. Okay, at the neutral pH value, almost all pH is 6, it forms the like 2, that is a neutral compound, one positive, one negative, which is equal to the neutral compound. So all the types of amino acid cannot forms the like COOH and NH2. So all the type of amino acid will give these type of NH3 plus and COO minus only. Okay, in case of like a strong acidic solution, at less than pH 2, which is lesser than the 2, then it appears as cations. So greater than the pH value 10, so which is appears as anions, Now I'll show these three compounds in a simple summary of the reaction, like a single line. Okay, now the summary of the reaction is, so summary of the zwitter ion reaction. Now here COO minus, it is NH3 plus. Okay, now here H, here it is the methyl. This is the alanine compound. Okay, in case of like a strong acidic solution, so that means lesser the pH value, here carboxylate anion will abstract the proton. Now it becomes COOH, CH, here it is the NH3 plus, here it is the methyl. So this is the first compound in case of less than pH value. So now in case of like strong basic solution, here our base will abstract the proton from ammonium cation. Now it converts into NH2, COO minus H, CH3. Okay, now let us consider the total overall charge on the complex. Now here only one plus is there. That's why here overall charge on the complex is plus one. Now here one plus and one minus. So both plus and minus will cancel to each other. Okay, now here only one minus. Okay, so now left to right, left to right, the pH value here, pH is equal to 2, here pH is equal to 6, here pH is equal to 10. That means on increasing the pH value, so now here it is the cation, it is the neutral compound, it is the negative charge. Okay, if increasing the pH value, so the zwitterion shapes are, zwitterion forms are different. Okay, now here which changes from plus 1 to 0, 0 to minus 1. This is the change we observed in like one of the zwitterion compound. Okay, so this is the final summary of the zwitterion compounds. Now let us discuss the next one, isoelectric point. Now the new term is isoelectric point. So now here it is the isoelectric point. Now in previous cases we will discuss the different pH values. It appears like cations or anions. That is the form of different types of zwitterions. Okay, now let us discuss here it is the a negative electrode. Here it is the a positive electrode. Let us assume here it is the negative and positive electrode. So in case of it is a solution, that is our amino acid solution. So in case of a solution is less than, pH is less than 2, that means it indicates it appeared as a cation. So if cations moves towards the a negative charged electrode, anions moves towards the positively charged electrodes. Now here, if it pH value more than 10, 9, that time of pH values, how much of pH values, it moves towards the positively charged electrode. Now less than pH, lesser pH value, it moves towards the anodic, negatively charged electrode value. But certain range of pH value, so these amino acid solution neither moves towards the cathode or nor moves towards the anode. Okay, so it cannot move towards either a positively charged electrode or negatively charged electrode. That particular pH value is called isoelectric point. Okay, I think it is clear. Okay, I'll explain one more time. So now here at a certain particular pH value, so our amino acid solution neither moves towards positively charged electrode or nor moves towards negatively charged electrodes. That particular pH value is called our isoelectric point, which is shown in, which is abbreviated PI, which is isoelectric point, which is abbreviated as PI. So generally, protonated amino acid, now here it is the simplest amino acid. Okay, now in case of protonated amino acid, that means here it is the cation, NH3+. So here protonated amino acid having two acidic protons. Now here it is the one acidic proton. Now here it is the second acidic proton. Okay, now how do you calculate the isoelectric point? I'll explain very clearly. Okay, now protonated amino acid having the two types of acidic protons. Okay, now however, I'll abstract the first acidic proton. Now I'll measure their Ka value. That is the first acidic constant value. Now if I'll abstract the second value, then that is the second Ka value, Ka1, Ka2. Based on the Ka acidic constant value, we will measure pKa1 and pKa2. Okay, now the mean, that is the mean value of these pKa values is nothing but our isoelectric point. Okay, so the average of these two pKa values, that is pKa1 plus pKa2. So pKa1 is nothing but acidic proton from carboxylic acid. So now here proton from ammonium cation by 2. So this is the simplest representation of isoelectric point. So now here first one, which is regarding to the pKa1 acidic proton. The second one is amine proton. Whenever protonated amino acid, which having the two types of amines. Now here these two types will calculated with the help of their pKa values. The average of these two pKa values, which is nothing but our isoelectric point. Whenever one amine functionality and one carboxylic acid functionality is present, then only it is possible. If ionizable side chains having the amines as well as carboxylic acids, this formula is not ruled. This formula is not applicable. Whenever this type of amino acid NH2, COOH, it having the either NH2 or it having the these type of compounds COOH, NH2, that is like COOH. Okay, so these type of compounds here it having the more than two acidic protons, such times. Now similar ionizable groups pKa values. Okay, now the average of similar ionizable pKa values in case of like basic amino acids. Now here it is NH3 plus and NH3 plus. These two pKa values mean is called our like isoelectric point. In case of acidic, both are like acidic compounds is called our isoelectric point. Now here it is the pI is equal to similarly ionizable. In case of basic compound, pKa 1 plus pKa, like here it is pKa 2 and pKa 3. It is pKa 1, so here 2. Here it is the pKa 3. So now in case of basic values, pKa 2 and pKa 3 by 2. Okay, that means here it is the similar type of ionizable groups values only calculated in isoelectric point. Now let us solve the one or two problems regarding to the isoelectric point. Now these problems are asked in like previous year CSIR, GATE, JEE mains, like such type of competitive exams. Now I'll give the one or two examples. Now let us solve these problems. PA value, that is the isoelectric point value. Okay, now it is the simplest compound, that is alanine. Okay, so in case of this type of alanine PAK values, that is the PA values, isoelectric point values. So this is the first pKa1, that is pKa1 plus pKa2 by 2. This is the average value. So pKa1 is 2.35, so pKa2 is 9.87 by 2. Okay, now let us calculate the value. 2 plus 9 plus 3, 12. So that is a 10, 12.2 by 2. Okay, so now we will get the 6.11. So this is the isoelectric point of alanine. Now in this case of like a basic amino acid, this is nothing but lysine. Okay, so these type of basic amino acids, now we will calculate the isoelectric point based on the like average of these three values. So many of the guys, they are ready to go for the average values. That why? Because here it is the average value, that's why here we will go through the average values of these three. So that is wrong, that is the wrong way. Okay, now here the average values of similarly ionizable groups. Now here NH3 plus and NH3 plus, both are ionized from the, like both protons will abstracted from the group. Now in this case, both protons will abstracted from the acidic group. Similarly ionizable groups average value is our pi. So now here one is a 10.79, so another one is a 8.95. These two values are like 14 and 17, like 19.74. okay, so now the values, it may be 9.87. Okay, this is the like pi value of lysine. Similarly, we will calculate the like glutamic acid. This is the glutamic acid. Okay, glutamic acid like isoelectric point. Now here the similarly ionizable groups values 4.25 plus 2.19 by 2. Now here is 4, like it is 4 plus 6.44 by 2, that is 3.22. This is the like isoelectric point of glutamic acid. This is the method to calculate the like isoelectric points of different ways. Okay, so these type of questions, they are asked in regularly like JEE mains as well as CSIR GATE exams also. Okay, now I'll explain another concept, that is like electrophoresis. Okay, now let us discuss the technique of electrophoresis. Now here it is the electrophoresis. So this is the technique which is used for the like separation of amino acids based on the like a stripping method. Okay, like whenever the presence of electric field, so the amino acids will be separated based on the like their pi values, that is isoelectric point values. Now let us assume so in a graph, so the electrophoresis, that means that the presence of electric field, so negatively charged species will move towards the positively charged electrode and positively charged species will move towards the negatively charged electrode. Okay, that is the thing which is called electrophoresis, this method is used for the like separation of amino acids. Now let us assume here it is the like a negatively charged electrode, here it is the positively charged electrode. Let us assume I don't want to go for the like a total electrochemistry of these like these type of compounds. So now here negative and positively charged species. Okay, now these type of negatively charged species and positively charged species, now we will take the like some of the solution that is a buffer solution. I'd like to take the solution pH 5 buffer solution, pH 5 buffer solution, that is nothing but acetate. Okay, now let us take the like a paper, like a stripping paper, that is a cellulose acetate paper. Okay, so in this case now I would like to like place the mixer of amino acids over here. So I would like to paste the mixer of amino acids over here. Okay, so this is the simplest representation. Now here it is the mixer of amino acids, mixer of amino acids. Okay, now here let us take the those mixes. One is like a glycine or lysine, that is a basic one. Another one is alanine. Okay, so now the final one is like a glutamic acid. Final one is glutamic acid. These three mixes. So now let us examine. So here it is A, here it is B, it is the C. Okay, so this is the like simplest representation. Whenever we will apply the some electricity through the these electrodes, now here these mixture of compounds will separate it. Okay, so whenever the lysine, that means here it is the like a these type of compounds, COOH and NH3. Here it is the plus, here it is the plus. Okay. So whenever these type of compounds, one negative and one positive charge will be neutral, but it appears as a cation. Okay, which appears as a cation. So cation moves towards the negatively charged species. Okay. Now in case of acidic compounds, to more than one acidic groups are there, that means here it is the negative values. Okay. That is the negative values, which is explained by the very simple thing. So now here pH value of the solution is less than pi. So that is the like acidic compound. Now it moves towards the negatively charged species. That is the cations. Okay. Now here these are the cations. So we'll move towards the negatively charged electrode. Negatively charged electrode. If pH value of the solution will greater than the pi, which is the anions, which are anions, will move towards the positively charged electrode. Okay, now let us examine here lysine value of the pi. In the previous case, we will calculate the lysine value, that is approximately 9 point something. Okay, now here pH of the buffer solution is 5. Now here the pi value is greater than that of the pH value, that is pH is less than that of the pi, both are same. Okay, now here pi value is less than, like greater than that of the pH value, now which gives the cations. Now in this case I have like basic compounds which having the like higher value, that is approximately 9 point something. Okay, so which gives the cations, cations moves towards the like negatively charged electrode. In the same case like glutamic acid, here the pH value is greater than that of the pi, which gives the anions, anions moves towards the positively charged species. Okay, now in this case whenever we will supply to some electric field, these purple, okay, this is the basal, this is the like a negatively charged electrode, this is the like a positively charged electrode. Okay, now at the end of like a this electrophoresis reaction. Okay, now here, so after the supplying the electric field, now negatively charged species, negatively charged electrode will okay now here whenever we will supply the like electricity through the these solution, now these solution, the cations will shift towards the negatively charged species. So cations, which is nothing but higher the pi values, among these three, that is A. So A species will move towards the negatively charged species, and anions, which is nothing but glutamic acid, so anions will move towards the positively charged species, that is the C. So now the neutral one, that is the alanine, will approximately placed at the B, which is very closer to the negatively charged. Why? Because it is a lesser positive charge, that's why it may be slightly shifted towards the negatively charged electrode. Okay, so this is the method to suppression of these three types of amino acids. Now after the completion of this electrophoresis method, now we will take these paper, that is these stripping paper. Now I'll take this stripping paper and cut
into several pieces based on our amino acids with the help of like several tests. Okay, so this is the method to separate the like amino acid, which is nothing but electrophoresis. Okay, that's all for this video. I'll explain those Zwitter ion as well as isoelectronic point as well as like electrophoresis method. Okay, if there is any possible, I'll explain many more reactions in our next videos. Okay, thank you for watching.